Then, how did you get so much money for traveling in a
family in rice in Iceland?
Hey guys, welcome to my channel, What's Up? So, if I have decided for a place to travel and I am revealing it to any of my relatives or colleagues who doesn't know me that well, these are the questions that I get.
What? Your husband is going on sale or what?
No, auntie. We're just traveling, so we just love to travel.
Then, how did you get so much money for traveling and all? Chumma Iceland lo mattum enna parannu undu vera pani onnum illa ochai.
As an answer to all those questions, and for all of you guys who think and budget is what stopping you from traveling, then you have come to the right place. Before we get started guys, if you're new to this channel, then providing videos related to food and travel, two of my favorite things in the world. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. As we speak now, I have just crossed 160 plus subscribers in my channel, and I'm really happy for all the subscribers who have done that. And I request you all to subscribe to my channel and make it and help me reach the 1000 mark, so that I'll be able to monetize this channel and thereby taking my videos to the next level. So let's get started. So the first and foremost point I'm going to talk about is plan your trip at least 1 year before, especially when you are going to visit an expensive country like Iceland. This is really important guys, because if you plan it out way ahead, you will be able to slash at least 30% of your expected expenses that you're going to spend in that country. How? First point, the flight expenses are prone to increase as we approach the dates closing. It applies to a lot of things like hotel booking, the travel inside the country, and everything. So make sure you guys plan your trip at least 1 year before, so that you get enough time to plan everything out. The second most important point is that you need to book the flight tickets at least 6 months before. This is again correlated to the first point that I have just said, but this is also equally important, because as we go near the dates of the travel, the flight cost tends to go higher and higher, and it will never help in optimized travel at all. So the best thing to do is to book flight tickets as early as you can, so that you don't miss out on the offers that all the flight companies has to offer. And you can also make use of websites called skyscanner.in, and you can always go incognito and refresh the flight tickets, and you can always make use of the credit card offers that you have. All those options will be run out with the flight tickets in the end. The most important point that I'm going to tell you guys is cover multiple countries in one go. Now you guys might be thinking, how stupid this is? I don't even have money to travel one country, then why would I even spend a lot of money traveling multiple countries? That's not the case guys, let me tell you one thing. India to Iceland. And as of now, as we speak, we don't have any direct flights from India to Iceland. Say I have booked a flight that lands in Copenhagen, and from there I have booked a connecting flight to Iceland. Iceland and Denmark are both Schengen countries, and Copenhagen is part of Denmark. So in this case, if I am going only for visiting Iceland, then what will happen is I would have missed the cost of visa. I would have missed the cost of flight that I have taken to reach Denmark. So instead, what I could have done is I can take a couple of days extension and book a stay in Copenhagen, and at least cover Copenhagen, so that you have at least one country extra that is listed on your passport. Just one scenario that I'm explaining to you guys. There are multiple other ways that you can do. We have done it a little differently, so which I will be explaining while I have started the Iceland series. I will be explaining to you guys from the planning stage till the end of the journey what all things we have done, so that you don't have to worry about anything at all if you are planning to visit Iceland. Stay tuned and subscribe to my channel guys, don't miss it. So the next and most important point is to choose the cheapest mode of transport once you have reached the destination. Say if you are visiting a northern European country, then most of the cases you will have very cheap public transport available there, like the subways, the trams, etc. And you can very well go ahead and choose them for roaming around the cities, or roaming around from one point to another. You can easily avail those public transports.
Now again, if you are going to visit a country like Iceland, what the other tourists would do there is get a rental vehicle and drive everything by themselves. They would do. So the best thing to do is do a thorough research on the modes of transport available in that country, not the one followed by the locals, but instead follow what the other tourists have already done. Again, all of the information are available in the internet and in the YouTube as well. In case you are specifically looking for something in Iceland, I am there to help you out. So if you are looking for an optimized cost of traveling, then there is nothing better than traveling in a group. You know, get a gaffer for a gang of like-minded people. It can be your colleagues, it can be your friends from your college or school. It can be anyone for that matter, but just form a group and align yourselves in such a way that the destination is common, and plan everything among yourselves so that the budgets are equally shared. The planning part is equally shared. Say for example, if you are planning the flight tickets part, your friends can plan, your one of your friends can plan the visa part, and everything is being equally divided, and you don't have to take the headache all by yourselves. And it would save a lot of cost when it comes to stay or the transport. Say if you are staying in a hotel or in a guest house, you can stay. If you are staying in one umbrella or one rooftop, then the budget is being equally shared as compared to you staying alone in a single place. And also, if you are going to rent out a rental car, take a rental car like we do in Iceland, even there the expenses will be equally shared as compared to doing a solo. Another important thing is, carry your food supplies with you. I mean that. You guys may be thinking, what she's saying, carry the food supplies with you. When I say food supplies, I meant non-perishable items like rice, sugar, salt. Now, you guys might be questioning me, are we going to a country like Iceland to cook or to have fun? Now, before judging me, in a country like Iceland, one coffee costs about 500 INR. So if a coffee costs that much, just imagine how much the other food items would be. So what we did instead was we have not only carried these non-perishable items, we have also carried a rice cooker along with us in case a burner or a stove or something is not available in the place where we're going to stay. Now obviously you will run out of your supplies. Your supplies are not going to last for a very long time. In those scenarios, there are a lot of grocery shops available even over there. Yeah, it is a little bit expensive, but not as expensive as the foods available in the restaurant. You can, anytime you can go and buy supplies from there, like your vegetables that you're going to cook, that you're going to need, some salt or some anything that you need for cooking your food on that particular day, you can go ahead and get that in the grocery stores available. There are a few rice paste available from Adyar Anandabhavan. It's also called A2B, and they are famously known as A2B rice paste, like lemon rice paste, tamarind rice paste and everything. So they were literally the lifesavers for us during our trip to Iceland. I mean, in the scenic beauty, we were having those, you know, home cooked tamarind rice in Iceland. That was a unique experience for us, and it was really wonderful. Another most important cost-effective travel that you can do is to avoid approaching any travel agencies for planning your trip. Advantage for people like us is that if you are spending 1 lakh for your trip, you will end up paying 2 lakhs if you are choosing the travel agencies. The reason being, yeah, they would not bother you, but they'll have to do all the research and R&Ds to get things done for you. So that is the charge that they are going to take if they are booking all your things. So instead, what you can do is, this again correlates to the first point that I have just said, that you will have to plan your trip way ahead so that you will get enough time to plan things out, like what kind of visa you're going to apply, how to book a flight ticket, how to book a flight ticket for at the cheaper cost, and what are the things going on in that country, what are the do's and don'ts there, where to stay. All of these things are available in the internet, and you can really do it by yourselves. Guys, these days, I rarely see people approach the travel agencies, but if someone recommends you that, then I think that should be the last thing that you. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. A lot of things, a lot of memories about Iceland has been popping up in my mind. I can't wait to start the travel series yet. Please make sure you guys subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on that. And if you guys have liked this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And comment down below the favorite country that you've ever visited or the favorite place that you've ever visited. Thank you so much. Until next time, it's Sai signing off. Bye bye.